As presented in lecture, in this course we use a simple 32-bit processor called the beta. The beta works on 32-bit instruction and data words. However, the addresses in memory are specified in bytes. A byte is made up of 8 bits, so each 32-bit instruction consists of 4 bytes. That means that if you have two instructions, A and B, in consecutive memory locations, if A is at address 0x100, then B is at address 0x104. Now, suppose that you're given the following piece of code. The dot equals zero notation tells you that your program begins at address 0. You can assume that execution begins at this location 0 and halts when the halt instruction is about to be executed. We want to determine what value ends up in R0 after this instruction sequence has been executed. Note that we are working with hexadecimal numbers in this code, and we want our answer to also be in hexadecimal. This code begins with a load operation into register R0. The load uses the value of R31 plus C as the source address for the load. Since R31 equals 0, this means that the value stored at address C is being loaded into R0. So after the load, R0 equals 0x300. Next, an add C of R0 with a constant B is performed, and that result is stored back into R0. The dot equals 0x200 notation immediately preceding the A label tells us that address A equals 0x200. This means that address B equals 0x204 and C equals 0x208. So, if we're adding the constant B to R0, R0 now becomes 0x300 plus 0x204, which equals 0x504. Now let's take a look at this short piece of code. Our goal is to determine the value left in R0 in hexadecimal. The dot equals zero notation once again tells us that our first instruction, the branch, is at address 0. The branch instruction then branches to location dot plus 4, which equals 0 plus 4, which equals 4. This is the address of the halt instruction. In addition to branching to the halt instruction, a branch instruction also stores the address of the instruction immediately following it into the destination register, R0 in this case. The address of the next instruction is 4. So R0 equals 0x4. Let's take a look at what this code is doing. It first loads the contents of address X into R0. So R0 equals 0x0FACE0FF, or 0x faceoff for short. It then moves the constant 0 into R1. So R1 equals 0. It now enters the loop where the AND C puts into R3 the least significant bit of R0. The ADD increments R1 if R3 equals 1. This means that if the least significant bit of R0 was a 1, then R1 is incremented by 1. Otherwise, R1 stays the same. The shift right constant then shifts R0 to the right by 1. This makes R0 have a 0 in the most significant bit, and the top 31 bits of what R0 used to be are shifted over by 1 position to the right. Note that this means that the least significant bit of the old R0 is now completely gone. That's okay though, because we already incremented R1 based on that original least significant bit of R0. The BNE, or branch are not equal, then branches back to loop as long as R0 is not equal to 0. This means that what this loop is doing is looking at the current least significant bit of R0, incrementing R1 if that bit is 1, and then shifting that bit out until all bits have been shifted out. In other words, it's counting the total number of 1s in the original value loaded from address X. The loop ends when all the ones have been counted, at which point R0 is left with a 0 in it because all the ones have been shifted out. R1 is left with a number of ones in the data, 0x0FACE0FF equals in binary 0000 1111 1010 1110 0000 1111 0000 1111 1111. There are 19 ones in 0x faceoff, so R1 equals 19, which equals 16 plus 3, which in hexadecimal equals 0x13. In this piece of code, the C move first sets the stack pointer to 0x1000. Then a push SP operation is performed. Let's first understand what a push instruction does. A push instruction is actually a macro made up of two beta instructions. To push a value onto the stack pointer is first incremented by 4 in order to point to the next empty location on the stack. This sets SP equal to 0x1004. Then, the contents of register RA, which is being pushed onto the stack, are stored at the memory location whose address is SP-4, which is address 0x1000. Now, looking at the actual push operation performed here, we are performing a push of stack pointer, so the RA register is also the stack pointer. This means that the value stored at location 0x1000 is actually the value of SP, which is 0x1004. So the value that got pushed onto the stack is 0x1004.